lucky to have him, with Inspector Drept taking offices so close. Should keep the riffraff at bay.
I haven't noticed any difference in the level of riffrafferty. In fact, I don't feel safe walking down my own street. And Wilson says there's an absolute throng of pagans that have taken over the park.
Throng, really? Is he sure it's pagans? Maybe they're just, you know, shabby.
Either way, when's the last time you enjoyed a stroll through the Auldale Public Gardens, Lady Cafferty?
Well, just the other... Was it... I'm sure I recall it wasn't too long ago.
So much for your Inspector Drept keeping us all safe.
Really, Oscar, you poo-poo everything. Besides, I really do feel safer.
I'll wager you only feel safe when you're in the pub, considering the inspector's workshop is right near there. Am I right?
Tut-tut. The discussion is over.
I never lose things. Maybe someone swiped it. Nah.
But why? Why? I can't even get into my own shop.
Yeah, about that. See, I decided it ain't your shop no more. It's mine.
You can't do that. I'll go to the city watch. I have friends in high places.
Sure, go tell your friends about how you sold me fool's gold. They'll be really extra special interested in that part. Are you sure you want your friends checking on the things you sold them over the years?
Well, the nerve of your insinuation.
Still, I don't see you running out the door to tell the city watch.
I could repay you. It would just take me a few days, gather the cash.
It's too late for that.
Fancy clothes.
Besides, it's more than just the money, see? I gotta make an example of you. Just so as everyone knows, they can't mess with Jimmy the Knife.
Well, I'll just go to my shop then and remove those boards myself.
Sure, you could try to play it that way. But if I see you doing it, I'm gonna have to kill you.
Kill me? You! You're the one who deserves to die!
That almost sounded like a threat, Fogarty, you worm. Don't make me make an example out of you. Now scram. I hate the sight of you.
What am I, made of money?
course they died, Amanda, old girl. The two of them didn't have half a brain between them.
Exactly my point, Zachary. The mother, now she had a brain and a plan. Women often do. The whole thing was her idea. Trouble is, they were too pea-brained to pull it off. Snuffed out by some security device, of course. But after, they were already inside the museum.
Well, if you're game, I am too. Should be an absolute bundle of fun. I can't wait to outwit a guard. I do hope they'll be guards. But we should do it soon, before the city watch discover that tunnel we found.
Really, Zachary? If they haven't found the tunnel yet, there's no reason to think they'll ever find it. No. There's time for more planning before our naughty little heist.
You're not going to spoil the fun and go all scaredy-cat on me, are you, Amanda?
Of course not, Zachy Poo. I just want everything to go perfectly. I mean, there's only one museum, and I don't want to rush in without the right outfit.
Quite right, darling. Proper attire. I hadn't thought of that.
Someone has cut my purse. The effrontery.
Sure, I saw anything anyway.
Bees you friend or foe, Sneaksy, huh? My bees have no fight with you, city man, yet.
Yeah. put that torch out.
Larkspur says B's watching you, man fool.
Who am I kidding? Everybody's asleep. Woke me up, though.
Ah, Garrett. It's been a long time. So long, in fact, I was sure you were dead or rotting in a cell somewhere. I guess I should have remembered how resourceful you are. Anyway, I suppose the polite thing to do would be to say hello, wouldn't it? Large hall, wouldn't you say? Been carrying it around for a while?
Idea of a joke?
Not bothers me.
Who am I kidding?
Does bother you?
Everybody's asleep.
This place hath nothing of value for thee to steal.
I'm more interested in those papers of yours. If they can tell me anything about a crone that talks to statues.
Thou hast seen the hag?
Not just seen. She tried to kill me, but I hear you've been trailing her for years.
Yea, I hath followed her trail, but it hath not been clear. I hath even doubted anon that her crimes weren't more than my own imaginings. That thou hast seen her as well. 'Twas in my boyhood, in the orphanage known as the Shale Bridge Cradle, that I spied her. I didst play at a game with mine friend, and I was hidden, and my friend sought me. Then a hag, a bent and evil apparition, came from the darkness, near enough to touch, and my friend did scream. But I was a child, and afraid. And then, 'twas over. The orphanage grew a dark and haunted place, and now none dare enter. When came I to my manhood, and was saved by the order of the hammer, I sought the hag again. The hag who wears death about her as a cloak. Some who meet her doth vanish, others perish with bloody work done upon their bodies. There are hints spoken of creatures made of stone. And ever the tale of a hag, a bent old woman, ever old, but growing no older, in a span that hath taken me from boyhood to mine own age.
Can you tell me how to find her?
She finds her prey now in Auldale. But 'twas in ShaleBridge her murders didst begin. Seekest thou a start upon her trail there? 'Tis the only place I hath e'er spied her for certain, but I dare never return to that place.
good place to start looking. I have no interest in being the latest in her string of murders.
Excuse me.
To the very bone. I was sure they'd have to resort to the knife. Doc says once you get rid of the bad humors, then the ox blood can do its job. That plus no bathing, still. Say, what's that on your hand? Oh, I don't know. Just a scrape, an abrasion or something. Nothing to worry about. Anyway, who's got money for a doctor, right?
Excuse me.